Before we had the QIAcube Connect, the issues were that the extractions were separate. I'm Preethi Gunaratne. I'm a professor in the Department of Biology and Biochemistry. I want to talk a little bit about the struggles we had with the working with the smallest of RNAs from our genome. While everybody else was looking at RNAs, we were looking at microRNAs and the RNAs and looking for things that are oppositely correlated and have binding sites. The microRNA extraction was a nightmare. It had to be, these are small RNAs, we had to run gels, we had to extract this from the gel slicers, and then we had such low inputs, you know, into sequencing, the sequence quality was very poor. I was very excited when QIAGEN developed the microRNA EC kit. And since you all also have the RNA EC kit, you know, we got very good at getting very good quality sequence reads for both microRNAs and RNAs. As we established our reputation, the sample numbers, you know, ramped up, and it's very hard to do gel slicing high throughput, right? So that was a huge benefit that we could run through lots of samples quickly, you know, gel-free, and then get this level of high quality. Now we have moved on to looking at long non-coding RNAs and also in the pre-cancer genome atlas. So at this moment, we are looking at trying to do remote sensing pre-cancerous lesions. The QIAcube Connect has significantly improved and enhanced our research. The ability to do it together and extract the two elements together in the same sample substantially sort of increases the scalability and throughput capabilities, but also the accuracy of our prediction. The hope in the future is to prevent cancer.
QIAGEN. Sample to insight.